Hi guys, I'm Alexis Marie, or the Real Blasian. I don't know why I always say that, but now it's a habit and I feel like I have to say it in all of my videos. Anywho, love my new nails. Thank you, Mindy Hardy. Well, anyways, I wanted to make this video like super quick because you guys have been asking me about the stuff that I use in my hair and what makeup I wear and stuff. I'm gonna tell you right now, I'm not a beauty guru or a hair guru or makeup guru or whatever they're called. I don't know how to do makeup. I don't really know how to do anything. I just like watch videos on YouTube and Google stuff, and I just use whatever I like. But yeah, so I'm gonna tell you some things that I usually use in my hair and whatever makeup I usually use. I don't really wear makeup often. I typically just wear moisturizer and sometimes just eyeliner. Sometimes I add mascara when I'm feeling fancy. I'm just kidding. I don't know, but that's usually just what I wear. Sometimes when I want to feel cute, this is what I do. But yeah, okay, so keep watching. Make sure you follow me on Instagram and Twitter, The Real Blasian, TheRealBlasian. And if you have any ideas or requests, go ahead and leave them in the comments below, or you could like tweet me. But yeah, so here we go. So I'm gonna start off with talking about hair stuff, but because I'm gonna do that, I'm gonna tell you a story about my trip to Alabama for a family reunion. I went to Alabama and I really wanted to get my hair done, which you can see I did, and ended up at a salon. They did a decent job. This isn't what I wanted, but they said they couldn't lift the color to what I wanted because I wanted it really blonde. But so yeah, got my hair done in Alabama, pretty decent time, free pink lemonade, very nice, you know, I was treated nicely. They had friendly conversation. It was lovely. So, after that, get back to the hotel. Here is what this story is about. I know it has nothing to do with my hair, but I wanted to just throw it in there because I got my hair done in Alabama. That's a way I could just connect it because this story is so funny. I have to tell you guys this story. Oh my God. You are not gonna believe this. Okay, so we happen to be staying in this hotel, and the reason we're staying in this one rather than, you know, I don't know, the Hilton, maybe Holiday Inn, maybe even Holiday Inn Express. No, we're staying in this one. I'm not gonna name it because I don't think that's a good idea. I'm sure that people might get mad at me, so I'm just not gonna say anything. But just know that this was like my worst hotel experience ever, and I will never ever come back. So first of all, you get there and you see it and you're like, okay, you know, this looks okay. I could probably deal with this. They have a nice little landscape, the big office, you know. I could probably do this. So, you get around the park, get out your car, unpacking, you know, feeling like this is gonna be a great family vacation, spend some time with some family, eat some food, black people food, because my dad is black and his family's black and they make some good food. Yeah, so you're like, you're stoked, ready, okay? So, you walk down the little area to get to where your room is, and you happen to see that little landscape in that area. Not all that nice. Not all that nice. But you know, go ahead, keep walking. You see a little bean-shaped pool. Come to find out that bean-shaped pool is extremely dirty. Can't even go swimming in it. Even though it's 8 feet deep, and it's shaped like a little lima bean, can't go swimming in it because it's disgusting. So you get inside the room, and it's a pretty decent room. Go ahead, look around the whole room, it's seeming pretty nice. So you go ahead, think, hey, you know what? I want to take a shower. I had a really long car ride, you know? I was in the car for like 7.5 hours, something like, I don't know. It was a long time. Stopping at rest stops, you know, but still, I want to take a shower. I feel like that is what I need to make this day just complete. So I go ahead, take my little happy butt in that little bathroom. You know, shower looks pretty nice. Looks like they kind of renovated the inside of it. So then you go ahead, get ready to get in the tub, right? Take a shower, turn on the water. Red water. Red water. The water was reddish orange. And I don't care if that was like rust in the pipes or whatever. Water should not be red. It just shouldn't. And that was like, that was like the worst moment I've ever experienced involving water. So anyways, that happens, but you know, the water turns clear, doesn't turn back red again. So you think, you know what? I'm gonna go ahead and take my shower. So get in the shower, and then you realize there's a vent in the shower that's covered in dust for no reason. Like, there's no switch for the fan, it doesn't ever come on, it's just in the shower. Creepy. So, you know, get out the shower. Realize the air conditioning is not cooling off the entire room. Actually, it's just getting the area right in front of it. The room's not cool at all. So I go spend some time with my family, cheer myself up some more, have some good food, you know, have some good times with good people. And come back, still room is not cool. But not only that, the refrigerator does not work. It does not cool the food off as it should. Everything is warm. Including the fresh new strawberries I had bought with the chocolate. I didn't get to eat not but a couple in the store. That was it. That's all I had because I brought them with us and the refrigerator didn't work. And so they went bad. I love strawberries. So they replaced that refrigerator. And that one didn't work. So I spend some more time with my family. Have a good time. Eat good food. Do fun things. Get home and my mom is awaiting me. I'm like, what could I have done? She shows me that this pillow, inside the pillowcase, she had just happened to look at it, I don't know why. It had mold on it, on the pillow, a lot of mold all over the pillow. How does that happen? And how does that go unnoticed? I don't know. So, you know, you think, this is terrible, I should leave. But you know, we gave it a chance. So this isn't even the end of the story. So we go ahead, keep going, get inside, we complain, we end up getting one free night, okay? But that's not the end of it, because there's baby spiders in there, there's a spider web in the corner that's already got food in it, there's a giant, one of those mosquito bugs, huge one in that web, and you gotta think, if it could catch that, it's gonna eat that, it's gotta be a pretty big spider, and it's got babies, and I'm just scared. So, then your mother tells you, oh hey, I forgot to tell you, look at this. And she shows me that if you kick in the bottom of the door, it opens at the bottom, like you can, there's like a hole, like it's just terrible, so somebody could have got in. And I was scared, didn't want to stay there, but they made me. So then your mom decides to tell you about a story that about how your dog was offered a cheeseburger, but she wouldn't even take the cheeseburger, she just kept staring towards the bathroom and barking. Which made me think that the room was haunted, and I was scared, and I didn't want to stay there. It was just terrible. I don't even know if I named everything. It was just so bad. Worst. Oh, no, I didn't. Also, the comforter thing was burnt. It had a cigarette burn in it. Bad. Just bad. Can't believe we actually stayed there. Anyways, back on to my beauty stuff. I'm gonna tell you about what I typically do in my hair. So as you can see, my hair looks different. It's straight and a different color. I didn't get my bangs cut differently, I decided to push them over because I made this eyebrow look okay and I wanted to show it off. But anyways, so typically I was using some products from curls.biz and they're all organic and I love them. They smell amazing and they always made my hair feel great, but I just ran out of them, so I don't have them to show you, but I usually use those. I can make a video about that later when I order more soon. You guys really need to get their products. They're amazing. So this is the protein treatment. This is the protein treatment that I use. So what you do is, I think that you have to shampoo your hair before you do it. I haven't done this in a while. The bottle I had actually went bad, and I just can't remember how to do it because I haven't done it in like months. So I think, yeah, you gotta shampoo your hair, but I don't have the shampoo because she told me I didn't have to get it at Sally's long, long, long time ago. So I shampoo my hair and then I put this in it and I use a comb and it gets really sticky. You just have to be really careful not to pull your hair when it's sticking together. It's so gross and it smells really bad, but it's amazing because it like leaves my hair feeling a lot healthier and smooth. So you do that, and then after having it dried under a medium heater, or heat dryer, hair dryer, I don't know, And then you're gonna wet it and rinse it like with warm water and get rid of all the excess dried protein. And like, you have to do it gently though. And then you're gonna towel dry, and then you're gonna apply this to your hair and scalp and leave it on for 2 minutes. I leave it on for a really long time because I like to really moisturize my hair. So I leave this on for way longer than 2 minutes. I don't really know, but yeah, I always leave it on really long because this makes my hair feel amazing. I just received these products from Simplicity Hair Oil, and they are amazing. I have the shampoo as well as the conditioner and the actual hair oil. And I've been using these lately and I love them, and I'm almost gone. Like, they're almost gone, and it makes me really sad because these are amazing. You guys really need to try these, especially if you're trying to go natural. It just made my hair feel so much healthier and nice. And it does have like different things in it that I don't even know what they are, but it really does make my hair feel nice. So this is like the one thing I kind of like don't care that it's not completely natural. Like, so I was interrupted by my mom with Panera. But it was really good. I'm really tired. I'm sorry. I need to hurry up and finish this video. So, I was saying I have the shampoo, the conditioner, and the hair oil. The shampoo actually cleanses my hair very well, and it smells amazing. And it has oils in it. I'm not going to go into detail, but it's actually sulfate-free, which I love about it. And yeah, I'm going to put the website for this in the description. Just make sure you guys check them out because they really are amazing, and it's completely worth buying. Although I have a lot of hair and I use a lot at a time, but I love it. And the conditioner, I don't like the way the conditioner smells really, but it definitely makes my hair, like it says, shinier, softer, and healthier. It really does though, seriously. Yeah. So then afterwards I put this, a few drops of this in my hair, like all over. I don't like, I hate the way it smells, but it definitely helps my hair a lot. So yeah, I guess that's actually about it when it comes to my hair. But as for makeup, what I do is I use this moisturizer. It is CoverGirl CG Smoothers BB Cream. SPF 21, 810, light to medium. This is what I use for my moisturizer. And then typically what I just use is that. And this eyeliner, I don't even remember who it's by because all the writing's gone. It's really old and it won't even shut right. I don't know why this always happens. I think it's by Maybelline. I don't really remember. I'm sorry, I failed you. But it looks like that. And then I use the Falsies Volume Express Flared by Maybelline New York. And when I feel really fancy, I use this, my 3D Fiber Lash Mascara by Unique. First, I put on some of that mascara, just a little bit, and then I put on the gel, and then I put on the fibers, and then I put gel again, and then fibers, and then gel again, I think. I think I put fibers on twice, usually. Unless I want like super, super witchy looking eyelashes because they look like spider legs. So usually I put on a primer, but I don't have it with me. After my primer, I use this MAC Studio Fix Fluid SPF 15 in NW35. This is what I've been using lately. Oh, and as for hair, sometimes when I want to have a little bit of hold for my hair, I actually use this Frizzy's Hair Serum Original Formula. But that is pretty much it. Make sure that you follow me on Instagram and Twitter. Leave comments below, like, favorite, and subscribe. Love you.